Today I've got 5 common problems when using Adobe Illustrator that you might have encountered yourself. I'm going to show you these problems as well as their solutions. So stay tuned in today's video on common problems in Adobe Illustrator. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. So today I've got 5 common problems that you might encounter when using Adobe Illustrator. This video is more geared towards beginners or intermediate users, and I'm sure we've all encountered one or more of these problems when using Adobe Illustrator. I want to reiterate that today's video is more geared towards beginners within Adobe Illustrator, and these are actually common issues that designers do run into. I know I've run into a lot of these issues in the start of my career, and on this channel I like to make videos for beginners as well as more advanced users. So if you do actually already know all of these or most of these points today, just understand that not every single upload on my channel is for intermediate and advanced designers. So the first annoying problem that you might encounter in Illustrator is that randomly your project might turn to grayscale. So for example, you might be working on a shape as part of your graphic design project, and even though you choose a color in the color palette, the design is still gray. I actually don't know why this happens, but if somebody does know, leave a comment in the comment section letting me know why this happens. But it has actually happened to me quite a few times. To rectify this problem, you simply need to open up the color window and then change the color mode to something else relevant to your design that is not grayscale. Another Illustrator problem that you might encounter and do not understand is the isolation function. So when you're working, this might happen during your design workflow. If you don't know what it is, it can be quite annoying. You simply need to click the top grey bar to remove it. But what is this thing? It's actually here so that you can isolate a specific part of your design, which can be very handy indeed. So for example, if I have this selection of shapes here, and even if they are all selected, I can double click one shape by itself and it becomes isolated. I can then make edits to that shape without the issue of selecting other shapes on the design. Another pretty annoying and common problem in Illustrator is when you're drawing with a pen tool, the pen tool might snap to a point where you don't want it to. So if you look carefully here, Illustrator is acting like a magnet and placing the pen tool in positions automatically. This is because I have the snap to point option activated in the preferences window, which you can lower the tolerance of or you can switch it off altogether. Also, in the older versions of Illustrator, there is an align to pixel grid option in the transform window, but I'm using the newer version. And so the location of that is actually here in the top right of the program. So have a look at these settings and see what it can do for your design workflow. The next annoying Illustrator problem is one that bugged me for a long, long time back in the day. When you're designing and you're trying to find a certain tool in the toolbar here on the left, you might accidentally press the perspective grid tool. If you don't know what this is or you don't know how to remove it, it can be very annoying, and sometimes people even save their document, close Illustrator and then reopen it. All you actually need to do is to go up to view here and then hide the perspective grid like so. The last annoying Illustrator problem is one that I've covered in an older video, and that is the zoom to selection function. So when you press Command or Control and Plus, you zoom into your document. You might want to zoom into the center of the screen, but if you have the zoom to selection activated, it will zoom to a specific design element on your project. You can turn this off in the preferences window. So there is today's video on common problems when using Adobe Illustrator. Let me know what you guys thought of today's video in the comment section below. Like and share my content if you do find it useful. And of course, subscribe to Satori Graphics for weekly graphic design content. And if you are subscribed, remember to turn on the notifications by clicking the bell icon to keep updated to all of my graphic design content. Now it's Friday, so the weekend's here, and I can't believe that it is actually already Friday. Last Friday only seems like 2 or 3 days ago to me, which is crazy, and it can't just be me who thinks that way. But however fast the week and the weekend goes by, have a great weekend everyone, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.